Hi guys, it's Nana from Mania, and I'm going to give you an update on my 40 gallon macro tank. As you guys know, I have made a DIY back sump. As of now, things are going great. And you can see I've added a pair of purple flame gobies. Basically, they were there with my LFS for like a month and a half, so I'm sure they are paired up. And you can see this peppermint shrimp picking on some food. My mandarin is doing fine. My DIY feeder, brine shrimp feeder, is also doing great. My mandarin always is hanging around close to it. Looks pretty fat and healthy. And at the same time, I'm having a really great cod population going on, because I've been feeding spirulina powder since I've started. So what I do is I do it like every alternate days. Like one day I feed them brine shrimps, and on the other day I just feed spirulina powder for my pods. And you guys can actually notice these tiny spots on the glass, which are actually pods. And yep, there are way too many pods. And also I'm getting some sort of really tiny free-flowing pods. They look like those extremely tiny jellyfish types, but now I don't know exactly what is it. And there's only one small issue which I'm facing, is that there are some crabs that are eating my feather call rapa. So I've lost a hell lot of feather call rapa. I could catch a few crabs, but there are still a few tiny crabs that are like hiding inside. Other than that, my tank is doing great. No other issues. My call rapa, as you guys can see, the coin call rapa, it's doing fantastic. Somehow my anemone is not doing that great. So I've made this DIY 2mm tank cover basically. As you guys know, my mandarin has been jumping, and also I've added flame gobies that are bound to jump. I made a small cut for this DIY brine shrimp feeder. That's my sump. Basically, you guys can see I don't have any sort of filter except for refugium and a big ball of chilo, which is like always floating around. And light, I think the light is pretty less. That's my brine shrimp. I cultivate brine shrimp every alternate days as right now. So that's it for the update, guys. There'll be many more updates soon, and I'm sure I'll be coming up with a lot of different type of DIY stuff, especially for my five fishes which I'm planning to add in this tank. I've decided on a few different types of DIY feeders, especially for pipe fishes. So let's see, I'm still waiting on some pipe fishes after my last pipe fish passed away. That's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you guys have liked it, please do subscribe and don't forget to hit the like button. Thank you.